Or lithium. Yeah, it looks like maybe this is where I can find lithium. Holy jeepers. Let's have a look around. A lot of the fuckers around here. Uh-huh, okay, yeah. Are we gonna talk about this? That one's red. Oh, fuck you! You didn't even make a fucking noise. But the other ones weren't red, were they? That's what made the sound. That thing. I don't know if the... Somebody's gonna have to tell me in the comments. Is that thing sound bugged? Because... It never seems to make sound, and when it does, it sounds like it cuts off, almost. Like, in all of the other, in the original Subnautica, all of the Leviathans made very unique sounds that you could hear from a great distance away, you know what I mean? This one doesn't, and when it does make a sound, it's, sounds a little broken. See, this is what I mean. I could have came over here at dark thinking I was heading the wrong way and wandered into that thing. So, yeah. Also, I'm not too afraid of it right now because, I'm going to be honest, it's not very scary, that thing. It's big, but looks more like a salmon mixed with a tuna. And I don't know about you, but tuna is delicious. There we go, that's what I was looking for. Yeah, we got lots of lithium now. That's good. So this is where you can go for your lithium hotspots, I guess. Just look for, like, the green, aqua-y green ground texture. There's more right there. Wait a minute. We went down there! That's, like, right next to that thing. How did we go down there without... Oh, I don't know. How much lithium do we get? Yeah, that's... I think that might be plenty of lithium for right now, then. Let's go ahead and get out of here. See that sound right there? That had to have been the, That had to... Oh. There it is, right there. That sound had to have been the freaking, the Leviathan. But notice how I heard it from that far away, and now I don't hear it. It's big, but it's not... It's just, I don't know. There you go, there's its sound. Okay, listen to that sound, guys. Is that sound scary? The Reaper is scary. The Ghost Leviathan sounds scary. The Sea Dragon sounds powerful. But see, that's the thing. I never found the sea dragon scary either in the original game. At first, it was like, oh my god, he's so big, that's kind of creep, you know? But I think most people agree that the sea dragon is not scary, he's just dangerous. And by that point, you know, because that biome, the lava biome, is kind of bright in color. And the sea dragon is more kind of like a final boss enemy that you try to work your way around. One you don't want to screw with. Everything else is creepy as hell. The worms, the ice worms, that's scary as hell because they burrow into the ground. You don't know when they're going to come up. That's why those things are unsettling as shit. So that's scary. This thing, not so much. I'm not saying it's a disappointment. I'm happy with the variety in creatures, and it's got a neat, sleek design. It just seems like they could have done better. Maybe with the sound. The sound is what bothers me the most, because sound design in Subnautica is supposed to be, you know, the best of the best from my experience with the first game. So much so that we're going to go scan it. Okay, it looks a little creepier now that we're up close. It makes whooshing noises. It also doesn't seem to be that aggressive, which is something I kind of like. See, it's not automatically targeting me. Well, when it looks at me, it might. That was actually a criticism I have still to this day. Oh, I don't want to get that close. That was actually a criticism I had with the original Subnautica to this day. That I feel like some of the creatures are... That's me! Oh, it has a cutscene! I think I got eaten. Considering the fact that it ate me whole, and there was lots of I lost all my lithium. Considering it ate me whole... did that save? Like, did that auto-save when I died? Because if it did, then we'll have to get all that lithium back. He should be floating there, though. I'm gonna try and see. There's no load function. There was no avoiding that, that's for sure. Anyways, as I was loading, I always felt that some of the creatures were a little bit too aggressive in the first game, including Leviathans, where they, if you were in anywhere within the same postcode as them, no matter what creatures were around them, no matter how hidden you were, nothing, they would just straight scream and beeline for you, even if you were behind them. And that always seemed just a little bit finicky to me. This guy we were able to swim with, basically, until he turned around and was like, ooh, munchy. And then we got eaten. Yeah, it was a little creepy when he was in my face. Won't lie about that. Overall, cool design. I mean, I would definitely, don't get me wrong, I'd be scared if that thing just appeared out of nowhere, like, behind me when I was trying to do something. There's no denying that. Unfortunately, I think we're going to be seeing more of the ice worms, though, which is the one right now that's really the scariest for me. I was told that that's the, it is a Leviathan class creature. I should have taken a bathroom break, to be honest, while it was loading. I also don't like loading into these places in the middle of the ocean, only because of my experience in the original Subnautica game from older versions of it, where if you saved the game and then loaded back in, you know, not in your life pod or in your base or whatever, you would sometimes load in and the ground wouldn't be loaded yet, and so you would be floating in void. And the creatures wouldn't have loaded in yet either, and considering I'm literally right next to a Leviathan-class creature where I saved. I got close to it, but it didn't give me a prompt to scan it, so I'm thinking maybe I have to be up next to its head to scan it, or it's not scannable yet, I don't know. One or the other, so... Let's go ahead and... Oh, he is a little too close for comfort right now. Let's let him... That guy would not leave this thing in one piece. In fact, he'd probably swallow the whole damn thing whole. The whole damn thing whole. Yeah, there it is. Yeah, see that? That one's red. I didn't think the ones over in that other area were red. It looked like they were blue. Maybe these, either it didn't look red because it was dark and blue like this biome, or those creatures are kind of like the ghost leviathans, where there's two different kinds in the game. One's a husband and one's a wife. No, one's a child and one's an adult. Why does it go so deep here? Hello, goodbye, screw off. Okay, well, we're coming back with lots of lithium, so... Huh? Oh, look at that. Inventory full times a million. Let's, drop one of these. Huh? Oh, fuck. I didn't think ahead. Do I not have any free space? Oh, no. I don't have any free space. There we go. Let's put all that in there. Oh, are you serious? It's connected to my fucking... Screw you, game. At least I won't have to line it up again. Inventory full again. There, okay. You need to go... Here. There. Okay. Mine. Now, hull strength is zero, so let's get some reinforcements built here. I'd say some good reinforcements can go on this side, because I'm not going to have windows on this side, I don't think. Yeah, that's plus seven. Holy nipples. One more on this side, that way we have plenty of strength to work with. Oop. What did I run out of? I ran out of titanium. Okay. Now, back on to what I was trying to do over here. Will it let me put... Yes, it will. Nice. Now, can I do it like this, actually? No, that's not enough room. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. What do I need? Titanium again? Yep. Bit of an awkward pathway to it, but it is just the generator, so, you know. The generator. Gotta remember, this base is gonna live on as the base I built in my first Subnautica Below Zero LP. Get this set up, and then I'm going to immediately get some sort of power going for it. Because at 72 meters, I don't know how well solar panels will work. There we go. and it overhangs just a little bit over nothing. Okay, right, we still have this weird thing where it, you can't put the multi-purpose room in the middle of it. You can only go on one of the four corners. I guess I didn't think about this much, about it overhanging this. Is there any, like, not too shitty way that I can put this here? Like that. Also put it there, but then it's still overhanging quite a bit. Why do I have to?
30 seconds.
Damn. That just overhangs too. I'm trying to find like a semi-clever way of making them connect. Well, I guess this thing can just float then, fuck it. Actually,
30 seconds.
Yeah, I've got a bit of an idea for this one here. Oh, now it's putting stuff down. You know what? Fuck it. I don't understand this game. Okay, so now let me fill up my air. Oxygen. Put a hatch right here. Oh, we need some quartz. I need one piece of quartz. Do we have any spare titanium anywhere? No. Okay.
Warning. Emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
Wow. This is more room than any man needs. I like the lighting, which is clearly coming from the twisty bridges. And I got this really awkward long walk to the the generator. There we go, nuclear reactor. We need an advanced wiring kit. Side. We need another plasteel ingot. We've got plenty of lithium. We need advanced wiring kit. Okay, yeah, we can do this. And then we can have some proper power in here with all those nuclear rods we got. And that's good, because we never did this in the original LP. Now we have it. Okay, so what do I need? Blueprints. We need a plasteel ingot. We need an advanced wiring kit. What was the other thing we needed? 3 lead. That's not too bad.
Seek fluid intake immediately.
Oh, I don't even have that. Do we have enough lead? There we go. We've got 3 lead now. Put the quartz away. 3 lead. Okay, we need a computer chip. And how do you make... We need 2 gold. Ah, shit. All the golden stuff is left back there. feels so much different when you've got this much maneuverability. Hold on, we need some water. Actually, it looks like we can use some food, too. Where did it go? Once again, I think I grabbed too much food.
Vital signs stabilizing.
Okay, we're gonna need like some reactor rod stuff, aren't we? What was that sound? That was steam, right? But it was an actual message, but it didn't come up on my overlay. Makes sense. Unless it did and I just missed it. I'm gonna bring some reactor rods with us, because I think it's 4 to fuel it. Because when we get that thing going, I want the rods on hand. And that way I could just use that place as a place for air. Okay. Yeah, okay, I've already seen that. Good. I was just making sure that wasn't another hidden message. Alright, while we're here, I'm also going to do this.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Take a battery out. Battery in. Okay, so I need 2 pieces of gold. There's 2 gold. I need a titanium ingot, and we don't have titanium. I need 2 more titaniums. And what does that chip take? We need 2 copper and 2 of those. Do I have any copper in here? I think I took it all with. Yeah, okay. So we've got 2 copper in there. Back at the place. I need a couple more titanium though first. Let's go this way this time. There's 1 titanium, and where is number 2? Inventory full. Shit, I didn't know I was that full. Alright, I'm gonna have to put something in here right now. Let's put these away. There we go. And this. Just temporarily, because I'm going to be transferring everything over anyways. I saw that limestone outcrop over here. I thought. Didn't I? Oh, right down there. Copper. Yes, of course. Titanium. There we go. We got our titanium. Copper. Nice, I can make the copper wire now. Where was that lead at? It was on the wall over here, I think. I'm never gonna find it, not in this grass. Maybe if I spend 10 years sifting through it, I'll find it at some point. Yeah, well, fine, we got plenty of lead anyways right now. This will clear up some inventory room. Let's go ahead and make titanium ingot. Bam. Plasteel ingot. Copper wire. Need the two table corals, and I need two silver ore, which I should have. No, I've got. There's one. Two. I've only got two. Jeez, we're very short on silver. There. Okay. Check my inventory. Yep, alright. We shouldn't have too much trouble finding the table coral. I'm having trouble finding the table coral. There's one. And there's another one. Good. Chip. Oh, the computer chip takes gold too. Oh, shit. Well, we should be able to. I'm not going to go all the way back just to get one gold. There should be some sandstone or whatever it's called in this game. There should be one of those outcrops somewhere over this direction. Is that a diamond? No, that's a Seamoth fragment. Lots of titanium stuff here. Lots of raw resources, period, actually. Anyways, yeah, coming up here, we should come across some of those outcrops. Should. That's silver, right? Yep. We need to look for the like soft bald head looking ones. That one right there. Might have gold in it. Have gold. Well, shit. Shouldn't be that hard though. Cause there's another one. Of course. Thank you, game. Got it. That's what I need, right? Yep. Okay.
Warning, emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
Oh, it made me jump. I was so happy. Oh boy, here we go. Yep, and you stick four rods in there. I don't know how much power this produces. It's apparently, from what I was told, it produces the most power out of any of the modules in the base Subnautica game, at least.